Welcome back to Pillars of Eternity Blind, the Let's Play of Awesomeness. We are here in Andra's Gift, and we've pretty much explored everywhere in here. We do have some miscellaneous quests to take care of. So let's get to them, I guess. Travel to Anstock's Compass, not yet. Oh yeah, we gotta return to him. And maybe kill him.
Got it.
Oh, we'll see. I don't wanna just go around killing people just because certain old houses want him dead. It's not much of a reason. But, which, if we don't, it means the House Domino won't be happy with us, which I suppose we'll have to fight them at some point.
How do you do?
Were you able to deliver the package? Was it a trap? If you'd told me the Dominoes were after you, it could have saved us both a lot of trouble. The Dominoes were there? Verzano's eyes fly open, and he tugs at his beard. I was so careful, always following the Verla Vita. They couldn't have known. What's happening now? Who's this? Is that the lady from the back room? Who wants to take over, maybe? Oh no, it's the other lady, Pallegina. Well, well, is this your last day among the living, Verzano? She wants him dead, too? Is she from House Domino? Verzano wrings his hands. Your timing is impeccable, Tella Pallegina. The Dominoes are after me. Please, you've got to stop them. As if any of this were ever in my hands. The Republic's considered your business worth protecting based on its success. That success depended on cooperations with the locals like House Domino. You've lost that. Her golden eyes narrow, and the favor of the Dukes. Let's just not say anything. Let's see how this plays out. Even if you get out of this alive, they're done with you. The Dukes have more pressing interests in Defiance Bay than rescuing one merchant who threw himself overboard. Rosano falls to his knees and claps his hands together. Have mercy, Pallegina. I don't stand a chance against the Dominoes. He bites a trembling lip. I've brought failure and shame on myself, but you can't mean to watch your countrymen die like a dog. Pallegina stares at Rosano for a long moment. The nictitating membranes of her eyes slide out and back before she continues. Sorry, guys. Verzano, Verzano, why are you wasting your precious breath on me? My orders come through the ambassador, and through the ambassador from people you should be honored ever gave a moment's thought to whether you live or die. You don't seem like the sort to petition the gods to keep him out of hell, so why not cry mercy to the one person in the room with the power to grant it? She turns her attention to you and raises her feathered eyebrows expectantly. I see no reason to protect him or to attack him. This isn't my business. Rosanna, you're on your own. I'm leaving after you pay me what I'm owed. Was that the clink of coins? A hard fate, but not unwarranted, she says. Verzano turns his tear-streaked face to you. I know you have a kind heart. Please, I never meant for either of us to come to harm. I only wanted to save my business. Don't let them slaughter me like this.
Do as you will. He's no longer my concern.
She turns her feathered head in your direction. Maybe we should protect him. Doesn't mean he has to die. And we're in the middle of it, apparently. Dana saunters through the door, flanked by a squad of Dominel foot soldiers. She lets her gloved hand rest on the hilt of her weapon. Does this mean we can't hang out in House Dominel? I hope you've collected whatever payment you are owed, because there won't be much left of this fool soon. As you leave the warehouse, you hear Verzano utter a shriek, which is quickly cut off. Okay, we left. Alrighty. It's showing us... I clicked on all costs. I washed my hands of the dispute between Master Verzano and House Dominel. Dana Dominel made short work of the merchant. Are they still in there? Is this place completely empty? That would be completely empty. Okay. I wonder. Still faintly bad. Okay. Our faction with Dominels hasn't dropped yet. We neither took part nor interrupted them with their plans, so... We remain neutral. I don't think we'll be able to remain neutral for long. Pallegina's over here? Is she a companion? If we can hire her on, that would be freaking awesome. And I'm afraid our ranger will go back to the, we just leveled her up. Hey! A bunch of... Speaking of leveling up...
Ah, it's done then.
Pallegina looks up with a satisfied expression.
You did the right thing. Verzano has no one to blame for this but himself. We gave him more than enough warnings, but he never listened.
She shakes her feathered head and smiles faintly.
In any case, the embassy's entanglements with him have been cut, which also means that I'm free from Verzano's net of stupidity. You have my thanks.
Not a problem.
Whether you intended to or not, you've done the Valian Republics a service today, ridding us of him. I work closely with the embassy to protect our interests, but lately I think our gaze has been too narrow. You clearly have pursuits of your own in the city, but I think we could help each other out, if you're interested in doing some work for us. Officially, I mean. We can go together and I'll introduce you to the ambassador.
That sounds fine. Let's go.
Good. Maybe I can finally do something more worthwhile than playing nanny to merchants. The embassy is up in First Fires, southwest of the Ducal Palace.
Ducal Palace? I was saying Ducal. Alright, bye, Sagani. She's just way too awesome. Nice. She's a paladin. Awesome. I've been wanting a paladin. All we need is a rogue type now. And I don't know who he'll replace. Maybe Canna, but I really like Canna. It's tough from here on in. Well, we'll see how Pallegina works out with the party. Check out a new paladin. Awesome! She has an air of like, I don't know. Of badassery. So she's an avian godlike. I didn't know that was one of the godlikes. Is that a godlike we can play? I know there was death and fire and moon and a couple others. She has a fine breastplate. These are her abilities. Avian godlike or naturally difficult to hit with ranged weapons, gaining a deflection bonus against all such attacks. Below 50% endurance, all avian godlike senses and movements become more precise, granting a bonus to perception and defense against disengagement attacks. She's awesome. Very impressed. Faith and conviction. A paladin's defenses are directly affected by the degree which he or she acts in accordance with the beliefs of his or her order. A bonus or a penalty is applied to defense based on how well the paladin's reputations align with his or her order's preferred behaviors. What is her deity? Where do I see this? Is this the god from us? Flames of devotion. Calls upon a paladin's inner fire, causing their equipped weapons to burst into flame and adding burn damage to their next attacks. Well, I hope that's a cool looking effect. Be better if it was like a more red or orange flame, I think. Lay on hands, yes. Plus 77.3 endurance. Fueled solely by belief, the paladin is able to heal with the touch of his or her hands, recovering a substantial amount of endurance for the paladin or an ally within range. Two per encounter. Nice. I think we're gonna kick butt with those undead things now. Hell yeah. Zealous focus. The paladin's intense and pure conviction instills clarity of purpose in him or her and all allies, increasing their accuracy and converting a portion of grazes to hits. Cannot be active with other zealous auras. Okay, plus 6 accuracy, 15% of grazes converted to hits. Modal. So that's that. Plus 5 deflection, plus 10 fortitude, 10 reflex, 10 will. Nice. Intense flames. Augments the powers of the paladin's flames of devotion, increasing its damage. Nice. Weapon focused soldier. Plus 6 accuracy with these weapons. Field triage, yeah. It's pretty awesome. You know, it'd be cool if they had like a little like biography here on where the character's background and stuff. Pretty awesome. Caw-caw! So she's got a fine greatsword and a fine pistol. Nice. Alright, that's really awesome. That's really, really awesome. Alright, what other quests do we have to do? Alright, we have to go to the Valian Embassy to do the quest she just gave us, right? No, first fires is this way.
So those feathers, that's a blessing of Helia?
So they say.
Well, that's lucky. Where I'm from, we see a feathered lady, we start worrying maybe her dad got frisky with his hens.
I guess you can always trust a farm boy's head to go there first.
Ooh, shots fired, shots fired. Retaliatory strike. Think I'm gonna like this group. Gonna talk to who again? Agosti? Oh, where the hell is Agosti? Oh, right here.
Ambassador Agosti, I would speak with you on a matter of some urgency and great importance.
Pallegina smiles broadly when she addresses the ambassador. Sighing as though remembering some heavy burden, Vicent crosses his arms before replying. Pallegina, if this is the same matter we previously discussed, I doubt I will be convinced any more easily. Ambassador, please hear her out. The ambassador appraises you for several moments and nods respectfully. You are well known in Defiance Bay, Theodas. He smiles softly, even in the Valian Embassy. Good thing they didn't realize we steal stuff. Vicent turns his attention back to Pallegina. So you're keeping respectful companies these days. He throws up his hands and shrugs. Hardly a good reason to go stirring up trouble with animancers and who knows else.
Ambassador, there are issues at stake here that go beyond rogue merchants and a port staying open. Animancy is under attack in Defiance Bay.
Pallegina shakes her feathered fists to emphasize her point. We have to protect our interests here, but that also means knowing when to avoid unnecessary entanglements. The animancers and the locals have problems. They'll work them out, or they won't. Either way, there's too much to risk by getting involved.
If it is outlawed here, what would prevent the same from happening in our republics?
The ambassador's face vacillates between expressions of sympathy and frustration. Pallegina, I do not think your concerns are unfounded, but it is not the place of this embassy to countermand the Republic's policies. Wow. So she's on the side of animancy. She doesn't want it outlawed. I think her and Aelath are going to have issues. If it makes any difference, Ambassador, I'm already looking into the matters Pallegina has spoken of. It doesn't, but it would be fortuitous if your investigation took you to Twin Elms, because that's where Pallegina needs to go.
What is it the Dukes need of me, Ambassador?
Pallegina recovers her determined demeanor. The Deerwood's instability has created an opportunity for us to take over their trade with Ir Glanfath. We need to meet with the Glanfathans soon to secure upcoming trade arrangements. The roads to Twin Elms can be dangerous, of course, but that's why you'll be our representative there.
Echosi, Ambassador. But won't this provoke the Deerwoodians? Their country is falling apart, and we're already dividing up their trade alliances.
Pallegina's feathers ruffle, but she speaks with an unusually meek timbre. Provoke them into what? Going to war? Through no fault of the Republic's, the Deerwood's armies have been deprived of an entire generation of soldiers. It would be foolish not to take advantage of the situation. If we don't, the Red Sarans will. Ambassador, that's some cold compassion considering what these people have been through.
More than that, Ambassador, there is a practical element to consider. We may profit in the short term from this arrangement, but what of the future? The Deerwood won't forget, and the Republics may pay the price for it.
We are not the Dukes, Pallegina. It's their decision and our job to carry out the orders. It's not like they're asking you to assassinate someone. Pallegina raises an eyebrow and clenches her jaw, but remains silent. Pallegina, Pallegina, he shakes his head. Go to Twin Elms. Speak to the Anemphath. Anemphath? Impress upon her the instability of the Deerwood and reassure her of the Valian Republic's desire to open safe trade.
Of course, Ambassador.
So after a long and uncomfortable pause, Pallegina exhales deeply, the lids of her eyes closing briefly as she slumps in acceptance. The ambassador nods and smiles paternally. He then looks to you. I know you plan on investigating this crisis together, but I hope you understand Palagina's responsibilities. I can't see the point of lying and winking obnoxiously at her. Then they're going to tell we're lying. I understand, but we're still going to investigate it, responsibilities or not. Vicent bristles and turns to Pallegina. Will the Dukes need to hear more about Pallegina Mizrai's wild adventures?
Of course not, Ambassador. I will attend to the unamend fort as soon as I am able to travel to Twin Elms.
Good. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Could have gone better. Could have gone worse.
Sorry, guys, on my phone.
I appreciate that you stood up for me. But it's hard to persuade the Ambassador to go against the Duke's orders.
I love her accent. I know you're right, Pallegina. We may find a way for you to fulfill your obligations while looking into what's really going on around here. Don't worry.
Enough wisdom for both of us. Now, I just need to find out how to get to Twin Elms before the Ambassador loses his patience.
We're not going there anytime soon. We still have to investigate the Lighthouse and Heritage Hill. She pauses in thought. Still, I fear that making this deal with the Glamfellens will further weaken the Deerwood and make trouble for the Republics in the years to come. Follow your heart. Do what you believe will be the best for the Republics.
I wish I knew.
Right, we gotta level these guys up. Aloth. Yeah, give him lore. Have you looked at these spells? Yeah, we have. Well, we could take one more. A weapon changed. Oh, yeah, he has to focus on that. That'll be his weapon. That's why I didn't choose that. Nice. Minoletta's bounding missiles. I kind of want to take these buffs and debuff spells, but let me just take this first. Okay. Arcane Veil. Conjures a protective shield of magic, dramatically boosting the wizard's deflection. Plus 50 deflection for 13 seconds. That's not very long. Grimoire Slam. Penetrating Blast. Damage Reduction Bypass. Or I can take something defensive. I might take this someday. You know what? Just to help him out. I'm gonna take this superior deflection. That'll help him not get hit so much. You dare? Another survival. Bonus knockdown. You know what? Yeah, we're all gonna take that. Because I use my knockdowns. Now that we don't have Firebrand in the party, we lost half of our knockdowns, so I'll take that. Minor adventure added. This quest expires in 1 day. Yeah, let's send Firebrand on an adventure. Can they die from this? Okay. Okay. Endurance. I'm gonna increase mechanics again. Until we find a roguey type, he's our rogue type. I'm gonna save the points for the next one. Talents. Brilliant Radiance. Enemies take burn damage from the Priest's Holy Radiance. Interdiction. Dazes enemies. Inspired Flame. The Faithful of Magrin gain an accuracy bonus. Aggrandizing Radiance. The priest gains a bonus to all attributes and movement, but everyone seems less healing. Oh, that's not cool. Let me take Brilliant Radiance. Sure to help.
Hello!
Amica, so good to see you again. What can I do for you? Pallegina said you could use my help with something. Ah, yes, very true. His jovial countenance hardens. I have heard word of Mr. Vizanner's death. While it is regrettable, even he had to know this fate was a possibility given the sort of people he was crossing. But, on to business. A rather notorious adventuring party calling themselves the Forgotten have made a name for themselves by raiding Ingwithin ruins in the Deerwood and selling the stolen relics to their patrons back in the Valian Republics. The Forgotten, huh? I need them stopped. I'm sure you're aware that trade in Ingwithin relics is strictly forbidden in the Deerwood. Were it known that prominent nobles in the Republics were flagrantly defying the Duke's ban on the looting of Ingwithin ruins, it would put a number of valuable trade agreements in jeopardy, or even cause Defiance Bay to embargo Valian goods. I can't let that happen. The authorities in Defiance Bay have no idea this smuggling is going on. I'm sure rumors have reached their ears, but if they suspected that there was any truth to them, they'd have summoned me before them. That hasn't happened yet. They're an adventuring party. They're like us. This is just like something we'd do. I'll help, I guess. What do you need me to do? He smiles in relief. Thank you. A prominent merchant in the Republic's, Mr. Brocosi, has also developed an interest in obtaining Ingwithin relics and sent a buyer to Defiance Bay to meet with the Forgotten. I arranged for the Knights of the Crucible to detain the buyer for questioning. I may have suggested that the buyer was a wanted criminal. I'll need you to go into the buyer's place, posing as Barcosi's representative, and learn how the Forgotten are smuggling the relics through Defiance Bay. With that knowledge, I can take the steps to discreetly dismantle their operation and discredit them in the eyes of their patrons. If there's nothing else, I must return to my duties. Go to Adelwan Bridge. Oh, you've been there. Oh, those are those people that were standing around by the bridge. I was wondering who the hell they were and what they were doing. We didn't have a lot of option to talk to them, so now we know. Huh. What else do we have to do? Quite a bit. A lighthouse. Thristwin at Brackenberry Inn, huh? Yeah, we gotta go back and talk to him. We gotta go back to the Revealed Mysteries. The cave is at some other point. Always from the past. Catacombs. Long Hunt. She has to rejoin us for this. I'll see how we can further this quest. The guy's dead now. I guess the Eater will let us know. Adair. Sorry. Anstock's compass again. Okay, there's a couple that we can do right here in town. Not that many, but a few. So we will do that. And the last thing we're going to do before we leave, move on to Heritage Hill, is tackle that lighthouse. So we're going to pretty much eliminate everything else in town first. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.